Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brother. I got married and divorced after a week with no valid reason. His excuse was I don't have the curvy body he likes, even though he had seen me before nikah. The hard part is I love him still. How do I let go? Let's hear the answer to this amazing question. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wa liyu salihin, wa ashadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, what an amazing question. The sister says that I got divorced after a week, meaning they were intimate, most likely, obviously. And, you know, they've consummated marriage and the guy was not supposedly satisfied with the way the woman looked. Now, we have to understand things properly. Let's put aside emotions and look at our fitrah. This deen is the deen of fitrah. Okay, Islam deen of fitrah. Allah has created men in a certain way and women in a certain way. Ya Allah, subhanAllah, the faster we understand our fitrah, our nature, and that is the nature that, subhanAllah, you know, we ignore over and over again. We think, the theory, yes, Islam says this, the Quran says that. We don't understand the relationship between the fitrah and Islam. So, revelation, wahi, has come to fine-tune our creation, our fitrah. Without revelation, we are lost. But the fitrah stands. Problem is today, people do not understand their fitrah. They don't understand male psychology and the male biology. They don't understand the female psychology and the female biology. And because of that, lack of knowledge, ignorance is problematic. People say ignorance is bliss. No, ignorance is destruction. All right, so guys are in a certain way, women are in a certain way, okay? So let us talk a little bit about this case here. This is about a guy. What do guys think about women's look? What do they see? First and foremost, guys have different looks or different preferences. Some guys like girls to be skinnier. Some like guys like girls to be more curvy. Some guys like girls to be fat. Yes, I have met those. Some guys like girls to look, I don't know, a certain way. Darker, lighter, it depends. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Indeed, it is so true. What I find beautiful, you might not. What I find attractive, you might not, and vice versa. Please understand, the faster you understand this, the easier it is for us to move forward in our development as Muslims. If we don't understand that, we get stuck in the same problems over and over again. So, this guy liked, it seemed, curvy women. Is he allowed to have a preference? Yes, he is. So, can men choose based on certain looks? Yes, they can. It is allowed. It is part of their right to be attracted to someone. That's why the concept of nikah, okay, of, you know, one of the objectives is sutra and protection, a sexual protection. And the Prophet ﷺ, when one man said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm going to get married. He said, did you see her? He says, no. He said, go see her. In some cases, even some, there's narration where Ashab was kind of like hiding, looking to see. I mean, you know, you have to see, okay? You have to have this nadhar to shara. You know, when you look at the woman, you know, you're not going to be like checking her all the time, but it's to see whether this woman is attractive to you. And she has the right to see you and to see if you're handsome and so on. So many brothers and sisters get married because their parents say, go ahead, bismillah, get married. They don't feel anything. I don't feel anything. Well, wait a second, bro. You're going to wake up next to this woman for the next, you know, how many years of your life till you pass away. There's going to be your wife. What do you mean? You're going to be intimate with her. How can you be intimate if you're not attracted? How am I going to feel attracted, brother? You're going to feel attracted, man. Come on, don't play around. You know if you're attracted or not to someone. Come on. This is built in our fitrah. Just by even seeing, being close, proximity, you feel a connection. It's not just about, people like, it's all about sex. It's all about sex. Problem is that this messed up Hollywood, Bollywood, Halaliwood, Lollywood, whatever is messed up. This, everything's about sex. It's not. Connection, chemistry, and yes, sex is there, but it's a connection between two human beings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put. Love and passion is part of that. Why do we make it look dirty? Because the kuffar made it look dirty. So we Muslims are like, oh my God. And what we do, we shortcut ourselves. and not being able to be intimate properly, not being able to be passionate and loving and so on, because we have these mental blocks that it's, you know, out of self-righteousness and piety that we cannot. So then we suffer. People fall apart like this. 1 week. All right. So let's understand the issue a bit deeper. Again, can the guy choose? Can he be attracted to this or that? Skinny, chubby, whatever. Yes, he can. He has the right to. The mistake he's done that he didn't understand it earlier. What is this like? You marry them for 1 week, you know, use them and then be like, okay, bye. You're not curvy. Here also we see this underlying problem of course, media, right? Because curvy women today is like pushed through propaganda, media, all this, the surgeries, they tighten their waist, there are all kinds of stuff, implants now, and not only in the breast, but also in the butts now, right? You got all this crazy stuff, right? So guys don't even realize, but you're conditioned. We are conditioned to like that. And the guy wakes up and he's like, oh my God, my wife doesn't look like, I don't know who, right? Kardashians or something like that. So, oh, I'm going to divorce her. Oh, I'm going to just leave her. Oh, I'm not fulfilled. I can't. 1 week. Come on, man. All right. You should have done your homework better. You check things out. I'm not saying go and be like, you know, measuring things and so on. But a man can kind of tell, man, what kind of man are you? Okay. So, and I tell guys and girls, don't jump into marriages if you're not fully 100% convinced. Do your istikhara. Do your istishara. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the same time, do your homework. Understand. See, kind of, you know, you're allowed. And many have said, you know, you can go to the house and see the woman in, you know, some decent clothes, in normal. Even some scholars said with that hijab for, you know, some have said that. Of course, some will say, no way. But I don't know. It's a difference of opinion, no doubt. I lean towards the fact that you can see. And again, it's not like you're going to be sitting around 2 months looking at each other, checking each other. No, it's like one, what's called the shari' look, to see if there's attraction. Okay, and some cultures everywhere, like the woman would come out and just serve the man something when he's sitting with her parents. And she's in just like, you know, normal clothes kind of thing. And he sees her, they look at each other kind of thing, and you know, it's just in human nature, you know. Do your homework, man, because you're going to mess yourself up, you're going to mess her up, you're going to take her virginity, and then, oh my God, you know, after 1 week, you let her go. All right? So, people need to make their, you know, decisions properly. There has to be, and yes, there has to be sexual attraction. Some people say, but it comes later, and this and that, because you don't understand what this attraction is. This is a connection that's felt sometimes right away. It's not love will develop. Emotions will develop. Maybe performance in intimacy can develop and get better with time. But that chemistry is very hard to just develop. It can happen through emotions, but I'm talking here about physical attraction. Okay? So people ignore that because they think, so, you know, self-righteous, self-pious, that Noah, we're going to be reading Quran all the time and making Qiyam. And come on, guys. Do you read Quran and Qiyam every day with your husband? Alhamdulillah if you do. Or with your wife. But come on, reality is most people don't. They do, alhamdulillah, read here and there. But I'm talking about, you know, people have the wrong understanding of what marriage is. They think it's just like, oh, we're going to marry and we're going to have this da'wah and this thing. Ya akhi, in the end, intimacy is important. Okay, attraction is important. Do your job properly. Do what you have to do properly. Bottom line is though, everyone has the right to choose what they like and what they feel attracted to, and they should, because an intimate, healthy relationship can solve a lot of things. That's one of the most important points. Another most important point, I'm not going to say second, is of course the connectivity when it comes to the deen and the taqwa and religion. If you're compatible in deen and you understand the deen the same way, alhamdulillah, marriage goes forth. And the second thing is, if you are compatible in intimacy and you go together, you there's a connection, subhanAllah, I can say pretty much as a counselor that no problems. Everything you'll be able to solve. Everything. If these two are solid, your deen and your intimate life, pretty much everything else you can handle and solve. So brothers and sisters, yes, personal preference is important. Yes, a lot of people are brainwashed by what's happening around. But in the end, do your homework. Make sure you're connected. Make sure there is chemistry. Because if not, you will suffer. And amongst this could be divorce. May Allah protect. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.